Welcome to my channel. I am ShellBell and today we are going to do a video on my new Doona stroller pram car seat. I still don't know what to call this. I did an unboxing video not long ago. If you want to see the unboxing video of this new contraption, go and have a look at that. I'll probably link it at the end or somewhere here. Today, we're going to do a really fun video where I show which size babies that I own fit in the Doona and which settings you need to have them on. So basically, what I'm like talking about when I say the settings, right now this is the newborn insert and the headrest with all of the padding and stuff in there that comes with the stroller when it comes out of the box. So that is what I have. I must have taken the strap covers off. Minus the strap covers. I've taken the strap covers off because I just don't... It's like on such a small baby, I just feel like they're so squishy and in the way. So this is my newborn, Nixon. He is the Chase by Body Brown. So he is a tiny sculpt. He wears 4 noughts. But he's like a small 4 knot kind of baby, if that makes sense. So that is how he fits in there. He's already in there, so I just thought I would leave him. And then I will get the next baby and see how I end up configuring the next baby. So my next baby, I'm thinking, I have another Chase by Bonnie Brown. I have the Landon kit, so he wears 0 to 3 months. I have my full body silicone. She wears 4 knots, which she's huge, but she also wears 4 knots. So maybe I'll put her in next and then maybe Onyx. After Onyx, we have Isabella, which is my Tobias sculpt. So she's a weird one. She wears between newborn up to double knot. She just has such a long body that she can wear like a big newborn size. I'm pretty sure the onesie she has on is newborn, but I feel like I might not have buttoned it up. And I think the little pants that she's wearing are also newborn, but they're like, they could go to like a 0 to 3 month baby as well. I do have my little wolf pup over there. I probably won't try. Maybe I will. She's just newborn, so probably not my wolf pup. After Isabella, I have my Earlies by Alicia Toner sculpt. So this is Ileana, and she wears about a 3 knot to a 2 knot as well. So she is a bigger, chunkier baby. She is so sweet and so realistic looking. So she'll go in after that. My final baby that I'm going to see if he fits in it is my Liam by Bonnie Brown. So he is a, I would definitely say he is a toddler sculpt. He wears size 0 and size 1. So he's definitely a big boy. I would say he's like 12 months to 1 year of age, maybe just a little bit more, a little bit older. And he is actually going to be leaving my collection as soon as he finds a mum. So I don't know if he will be gone or not. He looks so sweet right now. Like, he's beautifully painted, but I just am downsizing my collection for the moment. I just don't hang out with him that much. But I have posted a few videos with him recently, so hopefully you guys don't feel like you missed out on him. This is my full body silicone. She is about 20 inches, I believe. And I don't like how she's sitting in there. Like, I couldn't get the straps tight. Also, I don't want to ruin her and like cut her with the straps, which I know that probably sounds ridiculous, but she obviously still scares me. Yeah, so I feel like this bottom part, she's not sitting right, but her butt is all the way back here. I ended up pushing her butt and feet back and then like lifting her head up a bit. She looks okay, but I feel like it's not great. I don't love it. The configurations that I used are exactly the same as the first baby that was in here. So the straps are on the lowest level. I think that I would leave them on the lowest level. Maybe I would bring them up one. How much higher? No, they're way too high on the next level up. I leave them there. I think because she's a silicone and she's in this outfit and everything, I'm just maybe a little bit cautious of her. Alrighty, this is the Landon 3 month size in here. That train behind me. I like how you stop when I look at you. Are you a little bit hot? Have you had a drink? A kiss? Don't want a kiss. Kiss? Oh my god, he's so sweet. Kiss. Good boy. I don't know who taught me this, but whenever I've kissed a dog, I kiss them on the nose. And that's not... I don't know, look, it's just right there. Like, you can't kiss them on the mouth. It's like bitey down there. But this is nice and friendly and not bitey up here. Isn't that right, Klaus? Back to what I was saying. This is my 0 to 3 month baby, and I have put him in there with the same adjustments as I put the newborn babies in. I adjusted the straps a little bit looser, and he's in there pretty snug. This is really weird how it sits like over the hips. Is that normal? I thought that it sat higher up. It could be that it's like, I don't know, it's really weird. It's not supposed to go over the hips, it's supposed to like go up. Because like, can't that cause damage to the hips? Or is that just because it's from somewhere else and that's how it works? Like from a different country? I don't know. But he fits in there pretty nicely. I'd be happy to take him out. I love his little bunny, he loves his little bunny. He always has to be holding it. He just won't let go of it. You know, I was almost considering selling little Onyx, but he's so cute. Alrighty, look how happy she is just hanging in there. So, I was going to adjust the straps. Okay, it's like fallen off her shoulder now, I see. Not great. And I know why I couldn't get the straps tight, and that's because of my dodginess. So, what I was going to do was adjust the straps at the back, and then I was like, I don't really want to. I can't really be bothered to. If I was using it for the day and taking Bub out, then I would adjust the straps. But this little head cushion for a reborn doll, it's okay. This little head cushion has these little straps in the back, and it actually hooks on. Oh, can you see it? Hooks on to this strap, this harness. So you can see it goes around it. Therefore, when I am putting it in position and moving it up, sliding it up, it actually moves the harness. So, how do I explain that? The harness is coming from like the bottom hole, like down here. Oh my gosh, you can't see. Yes, that hole there. The light near my finger. And it should really be coming from at least the next one up. But because this head cushion like moves it up, it kind of works all right, but that just means you're not going to get a tight fit in the harness. Oh, what's going on here? Look at what is going on. Let me just loosen it a little bit. So if we're wanting correct fitment, we are going to have to ensure that these are in the correct slot. And what I mean by that is if you come, oops, across to the back, there are three choices for the straps to be in. I dare say she would be definitely on the middle one. So to make her fit in there a little bit nicer and it wouldn't pull her, because all it's trying to do is go over her shoulder and pull her down. Like it's just trying to go down into here. So it just wants to pull her shoulders down. If it was the next one higher, it's going to just try and pull her back. And that's kind of an importance about, you know, securing children's car seats correctly and making sure that their straps are at the correct height so that they work properly. But she still has the insert in there, the head support. This crotch, what is this? Like a cover on the inside. I have been like pulling it up so that the harness is more on here and not on the legs, because we don't want it on the legs. We want it kind of up here. It still sits funny over the legs like that. Again, I don't know if this is just like a little slightly different to Australian standards and I'm not used to it or something, or if it's just me not being able to figure it out, or if it's because the padding is in the bottom. I don't know. Get enough of this baby. She is just divine. Look at how sweet she is. This baby is the double naught / 0 to 3 month baby. So 3 months, maybe like 5 months, maybe not quite 5 months, maybe like 4 months. She is a sweetheart. Oh my gosh, like she just looks so good in there. The insert, I thought about taking the insert out, and when I took it out, it just looked like so big in there. So I put it back in and I think that she fits okay. I'm going to have a photo of all of the babies, well, all of the reborns that I've tested in their outfits on Instagram if you want to have a look at that. Just so you can see like a side-by-side comparison of each of the sizes of the babies. What am I even looking at? I'm not gonna lie. I thought that he was gonna fit. And then I picked him up from his pram that he was sitting in and I was like, he is not going to fit. He is huge. But the straps are on the highest point and I'm pretty sure that they are right. So they are just about here. That's really quite hard to see. They do go down a little bit. They are just, oh my gosh, I can see them. Why can't you? They're just there. You can see them. So they're like just in there. So for a rear facing car seat, they are a little allowed to be a little bit lower than the baby's shoulders. And I think that he would just fit. Like you wouldn't like have much longer left in there. But for a reborn, for the Liam by Body Brown Sculpt, as like a 12-month-old baby, or maybe like a 14-month, I don't know, he's little, he would fit in there, and I just think that that's really awesome. I feel like he is in there comfortably. I took this insert out. I do have the strap covers, but I don't know if I like strap covers. I just prefer like a clean fit on the harness and I know that it's like tight and whatever. This probably can go a bit tighter. But yeah, and I feel like he fits in there really well. This strap fits the best, like down here, but it still kind of goes over the hips. I don't know why that looks so weird to me. It's probably me just like, I don't know. I'm probably like, that's probably how all of the car seats are, and I'm just like looking at it weird. Don't know. But yeah, I can't believe that. I am actually kind of shocked because, like I said, once I looked at it, I was like, not going to fit. Look how cute he is. I have this little guy up for sale as well. And I have him in this outfit, and this outfit is not going home with him, but I really just love this little outfit. And like looking at him now, it just makes me want to keep him. Like, he's painted so beautifully. And his hair is beautiful, but I just don't use him. He's so big, but he's just so cute. I guess if he doesn't sell, he will have to stay here. So until he sells, he will just continue to live in the nursery, rent free. No, I'm kidding. That was a really fun video. Well, I thought it was. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I have some other videos on the Doona stroller car seat, such as an unboxing, and I will do a review on it as well, which is yet to come. I have lots of other babies in my collection and do other videos with them, such as outings, role play videos, like morning routines. I use the babysit me app with them. So if you like the sound of any of those videos, don't forget to subscribe. If you have already subscribed, don't forget to hit that bell notification so you know when I upload and you don't miss anything. I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching.